You'd better get out of here!
I posted the quest on the ship's board! Came from the Thelos Islands, one of the cultists there, Alexios. His name is Mohargis.
You reading my messages, Varnavas?
I may have taken a peek. Did you find what you were looking for in Athens?
With your crews, but this won't be easy.
Well, it's a good start! All we can do now is trust the path the gods have laid out for us.
I'm not the only one looking for my mother. The cult that wanted Nikolaus dead, they're also on the trail.
Ah, they're no match for you.
You got that right.
Salvage nearby! Layla was built to survive the worst storms and the toughest battles. But she was meant to sail on waters as glorious as this.
By all the gods, it's hot in here. Hephaestus sure seems angry. I wonder if it's because of the war.
Thank you.
Gorophone was an extraordinary woman born of Andromeda, daughter of the proud queen and king of Ethiopia, and Perseus, the Gorgon Slayer after whom she's named. It has long been tradition that women should marry but once, as virgins. If their husbands died before them, they were to live out their lives as widows. Gorophone defied this tradition to become the greatest grandmother of Hellas. It is said that a warrior woman of advanced age brought so much chaos to the people of Lake Tritonis that Perseus himself arrived to take her life. And some wise people say that was Gorgophone enjoying her last act of rebellion. Gorgophone's first husband was Pieres, king of Messene and Sparta. Their sons grew up to be bold princes and kings of Sparta themselves. Thank you. But Gorgophoni had a second husband, King Oivalos of Sparta, who would bring her even greater children and grandchildren. Helen of Troy, Castor and Polydeftes, Clytemnestra, and many more were her descendants. This helmet seems common, but it's been carefully hidden. I should get it back to that woman.
commander's left the helm!
That burning island and trapped tomb, you could say they were nearly a challenge.
Even for you. You exaggerate, Eagle Bearer. But did you find the helmet?
Of course I did. But how could you have known about such a terrible place? And who are you to send me there?
Who do you think I am, Alexios? Some say I show great wisdom. Others say I am wisdom herself. Tell me, who do you think I am?
You sent me to a graveyard, where I met a desperate man who said Athena herself had sent me to kill him. But I suppose that could mean he only thought you were Athena.
It's unwise to give too much credit to the rantings of a madman.
Then you sent me to a pirate in need, who asked me to help him as he saw fit. Was that a divine test of wisdom, or just practicality?
You sent yourself to a pirate. I merely provided the chance.
Finally, that strange hermit with the key. He was even under a statue of Athena's icon, the Owl. Did you set that all up as a joke, or is there truth in his beliefs?
So many thoughts in that head of yours. It's nearly too much to contemplate. Make your decision, Alexios.
As grandson of Leonidas, bearer of the bloodline, I must recognize you as Athena. This helmet you have asked me to return bears your own blessing.
If this is true, I should accept your recognizance. But for now, let me see that helmet.
I hope this was worth it.
You have great faith in humanity. I hope you see it for both its potential and its failings. I'll make an adjustment and... Yes, I think this will be best suited for you.
Thank you.
I hope you've gained some wisdom from this journey.
Yes, I've learned that profit can come from the strangest sources.